Hi guys, how you doing? I want to talk briefly about helmets today and airbrushing them, and I want to show you the latest one that I've just completed. It is a display helmet. It's not meant to be used on the road. It's just something that I will take to shows and bike nights, all that type of thing, just to kind of showcase what it is that I do. No further ado, let me show you it. Here we are. One Deadpool. It's an old Shoei helmet that was actually donated to me by a customer who's Harley that I airbrushed. He's actually dropped it a couple of times and it just came out of my shelf. He wasn't going to wear it anymore, so he just decided to give it to me to use. And one of the reasons that I chose the Deadpool design for this is one, laziness. It's quite easy to do, it's quite straightforward, there's not a lot of work involved in it. But this little kink at the back here is kind of indicative of the fold that he has in his mask at the rear, so I thought that kind of fitted it perfectly. Now you will notice that I have just painted directly onto the visor and cleared it as well. There is a reason for that. One, obviously it's just a display helmet, as I say, because it's been damaged, or rather because it's been dropped and we don't know what the damage is to it, it's never going to be used on the road, so it really doesn't matter. So it is only ever going to sit on a shelf, or it's going to be sitting out at a table, as I say, at bike nights and shows. But one of the reasons is durability. When you do display helmets like this, or when I do anyway, I tend not to look after them all that well. You know, they get thrown in and out the back of my Jeep along with all the other crap that I'm carrying about with me to these shows. So they kind of get rattled about a bit, you know, okay, they're covered with bubble wrap and that, but you just never know just how well protected they are. So it's from a durability point of view that I did this, because the normal procedure for doing this is to put a, what they call a contravision vinyl, which is a perforated vinyl, and then you paint on top of that. You'll have seen it online countless times. I actually have some of it here, which I'll show you. This is it here. Essentially it's a sort of perforated vinyl. Now I can show you just what it's like. And that, if I put that over the lens there, kind of gives you an idea of what you'd actually see through the helmet. You know, it's, you can see, but it's not great. It's certainly not road legal here in the UK anyway. You know, if you're seen by the police with this on your helmet, you will get pulled for it. It's not something I do a lot of with this stuff, simply for that reason. You know, why bother going to all that effort if, you know, you can't wear it on the road? The other thing with it is this is not the most durable product in the world, and even using solvent paints on it, what you can find is that if anything rubs against the surface quite hard, it will take the paint off, because there's no way of really keying into it and lacquering it or protecting it in any way. So you know, it's susceptible to damage in that sense. So again, you know, if this is getting thrown in at the back of my Jeep, you know, I don't want this rubbing against things and taking the paint off, getting damaged, and then me having to repair it several times a year. The other issue with it is obviously because it's a vinyl, you have to stretch it, and you know, heat it up and stretch it around to fit onto the visor. Over time it will start to contract, it will try and get back to its original shape, so it's not the greatest for that either. I've found that usually after about a year it starts to get a bit shitty looking and it needs to be replaced. And I can't be bothered with that. I've not got the time or the patience for it. So that was the reason for just painting directly onto the visor. It's just kind of say, look, this is the type of thing we could do. If you want it done on that, I can do it for you. If not, you know, you can quite easily just swap that out for a tinted visor that would still look quite cool. So yeah, that's the reason for it. If you are using this, what you have to do with it is you cut the template for your visor, and then you have to tape this down onto your visor with the backing paper still on it. You then paint a design on it, take it off, remove your backing, and then apply it to your visor. Now, one of the problems is because you have to heat this and stretch it, when you put it down, you can actually distort the design or the artwork that you've put on it. I've not had any major problems with it, but it is something that potentially can happen, especially with designs like Spider-Man helmets, where you have very precise lines where they must meet, and similar to this idea here, where you have this section of the mask coming down, you know, these lines have to meet. If you have to stretch that and it goes off, you know, even a couple of millimeters is enough to kind of make your helmet look a bit naff and not very good. So I tend not to use it all that often. I don't get many requests for it, in fairness, thankfully. But yeah, it's a bit of a bugger of a thing to work with, and it's not the most durable, so that's why I've not used it. If you are thinking of painting helmets, you want to have a go at it, what I would suggest is, especially if it's your own helmet, and it's even more so if you want to do it for other people, is to take a professional course or some kind of professional instruction on how to do it, because there's a lot that can go wrong painting helmets. And you know, I'm not just talking about reactions with paint and things like, you know, all the kind of normal things. The major one is the lacquer getting into the filling. Now, the lacquer that's on this helmet is a 2K lacquer, just like you would put on your car, your bike tanks, any sort of automotive items. And what can happen with a helmet is that unless the helmet is completely sealed, and I'm talking like the air vents here, all your air vents here, if any of that lacquer, when you're spraying it, seeps into the filling inside the helmet, it will actually dissolve the filling. There is a video somewhere online you can actually watch where someone actually does take a 2K clear, mix in a cup and pours it onto film, and you actually see it dissolve right in front of your eyes. I mean, the reaction is very, very quick. Ultimately, if you're spending, you won't actually see it happen when you're doing the helmet, but it'll be happening inside. And, you know, suffice to say that if someone whose helmet you've painted for has that problem and they have an accident, then you've knackered the integrity of the helmet and potentially, you know, their safety as well. So it is something I would recommend that you get professional instruction in some form or another. There are numerous airbrush courses that you can go on to learn to do, specifically just to do helmets, that are very worthwhile. They're only a few hundred pounds, which might seem a lot of money, but when you're talking, I mean, really, the course fee, you paint two helmets and you've got your money back. You know, they are worth doing. And these courses will teach you how to remove the rubbers and replace them all, which is very important to do, because you don't want your lacquer just sitting, you actually want it to be underneath your rubber. It gives a much better paint job and less chance of anything going wrong down the line as well, and your customers coming back to you and complaining. So, you know, if you want to do helmets, learn to do them right, okay? It's, you know, if you want to do your own, I suppose it's up to you really what you do, but I would strongly recommend that you take a professional course in doing it. If you don't want to go down that route and you want to paint your own helmet, I would suggest you use something like a nitrocellulose lacquer. Now, it's not the best thing for it, it's not the most durable, it's not the most long-lasting of lacquers, but it's a hell of a lot more forgiving and it won't affect the filling in the helmet. With a nitrocellulose lacquer, I mean, traditionally, nowadays, really, it's mainly just guitars that are used with nitro. And unlike a 2K, what a nitro does is it tends to melt into itself. And it doesn't have those kind of harsh chemicals that are contained within a 2K clear. So it's safer to use at home. You would still need to wear some form of respirator, a twin cartridge respirator, something like that. Because you don't want that shit in your lungs, okay? 2K clear, really, it needs to be sprayed in a booth, okay? You shouldn't be spraying that stuff at home. It needs to be sprayed in a paint booth. It is very, very dangerous stuff, and it can and will kill you if you're not careful. So, you know, if you wouldn't want to spray that, try and make friends with somebody with a paint booth. That's all I'll say. I'm fortunate enough that one of the companies that I do airbrushing for allow me the use of their paint booth for doing things like this, kind of as and when I want, really. You know, as long as the paint booth's clear and no one's using it, I'm free to kind of come and go as I please. So I'm very fortunate in that sense. But yeah, 2K and helmets is not something to be messed with. So, you know, please, if you want to do it, and especially if you want to do it on a commercial level and actually do it for people, take proper instruction. It's well worth doing. But that's it. Deadpool helmet done. I have got 5 other display helmets. These are all used helmets that I've bought from markets or been just donated to me. I've got another 2 coming in that people are wanting to just give to me. They've got them sitting about. They're going to throw them out, so they might as well have them. I will try and put up a step-by-step video of doing one of the helmets if I have the time to do it. I'm kind of pushed for time just now, and making videos takes a lot of time and a lot of effort that I just don't have at the minute. I will try and put a video up. I'll keep you posted with how things are going with that. But that is it just now. I hope you all enjoy the rest of your day, and thank you very much for watching. If you haven't subscribed, please click subscribe. And if you have any questions, as always, just pop them down in the comments below, and I'll do my best to answer them as soon as I can. Thank you very much, guys. Have a great day, and I'll see you all later.